Hello, Lakers Nation. Welcome in. It's game day, Lakers Pelicans final game of the regular season. Want to break down real quick the injury update, how everything's looking on that front, what we need to see from the Lakers today, because this is a big one before I dive into it. Quick reminder, everybody, come join us over on Playback, playback.tv/Lakers Nation. That's where you can watch the game directly with us, hang out with us during the game. It's a lot of fun. Also, you can hang out over on the Lakers Nation YouTube channel, youtube.com/Lakers Nation, another place where you can hang out and watch the game directly with us, and we can get through all of this together. So, all of that certainly important to for us to manage this game, and hopefully we can all get through it together. But all right, the injury report: Anthony Davis, LeBron James, they should be good to go here. Both listed as probable on the injury report yesterday, so we should be just fine there. As for the Pelican side, Brandon Ingram, he's listed as questionable. He's playing. Come on, we know he's going to play, because he saw Lakers on the schedule, right? That's what it is. But this is a big game for, of course, for the Lakers. This matters a ton for the Lakers. Essentially, the way they have to look at it is win and they're the 8th seed, lose and they're the 10th seed. Because I don't trust the Warriors or the Kings to lose their matchups against the Blazers or the Jazz. Well, let's face it. I really don't trust the Jazz or the Blazers to beat either one of those teams. So win and you're the 8th seed, lose and you're the 10th seed. That's the way the Lakers have to be approaching this. From the Pelican side, though, if they lose, they could potentially drop into the play-in, and that's not where they want to be. So expect the Pelicans to go all out. I know both sides have been talking about this being essentially a playoff game for them. So I'm expecting a full intensity. Everybody's going all out, 100% this game. I think it's going to be an exciting game. Hopefully, obviously, the Lakers get a win. But in order to do that, here's what they've got to do. I think that the Lakers have got to make sure, number one, that they get D'Angelo Russell back on track. He's been in a bit of a shooting slump. He's so important, his three-point shooting, to this Lakers team. They've got to get him going. D'Lo, it's time to snap out of that slump. I'm not mentioning LeBron and AD because, well, I kind of expect them to do what they do. I expect both LeBron and AD to turn it up. Anthony Davis, I guess my biggest key is stay out of foul trouble, but hopefully he does that. Otherwise, it's D'Lo. D'Lo's got to step up, and he's got to get that three-point shot falling. It makes the Lakers such a difficult team to beat when D'Lo has this dropping. So that's what I'm looking for. D'Angelo Russell, let's get things going on that end. And then defensively, what are the Lakers going to do with the quick guard and C.J. McCollum? He tends to hit annoying shots, just these tough shots, late in shot clocks. He'll hit a 20-footer or whatever. He's been on a tear lately. How the Lakers defend C.J. McCollum is going to be critical. Speaking of defense, another thing that I'm keeping an eye on, who do the Lakers scheme open in terms of the Pelicans? We've seen them do it all season long. Right or wrong, the Lakers tend to pick specific guys that they want shooting the basketball, and sometimes it's burned them. We saw it with Draymond Green with the Warriors. We saw it with Dante Exum. Marcus Smart did it to the Lakers earlier. Who is it that is going to be schemed open, and are they going to have a big game? I'm keeping an eye on Jonas Valanciunas. The Lakers, I'm sure, will dare him to shoot threes. If he happens to have a hot shooting game from deep, he hits a couple, that could be a problem. Then you look to some of the other guys that the Pelicans have. Of course, you've got to cover a guy like Trey Murphy, but what about Herb Jones? Could Herb Jones knock in a few threes for the Pels? That's going to be important. I know the Lakers defense is going to scheme some guys open, but hopefully, fingers crossed, and it feels terrible saying this, but the Lakers defense, you're kind of just hoping those guys miss their shots, because if they hit their shots that the Lakers are scheming them open for, that's going to be really tough to get a win. The other thing, the other Pelicans players, talking about guys like Jose Alvarado, what you can't have is a blow-up game from a random Pelicans role player. And unfortunately, those do tend to happen when the team is playing at home. So that home New Orleans crowd that's going to be on the Pelicans side, the Lakers have got to do what they can to lock in defensively, try to get stops. I know they haven't been a great defensive team since the All-Star break, but they got to do their best to get stops and keep the Pelicans from getting those big uplifting plays, those energy plays from guys like Alvarado. Again, Herb Jones, Valanciunas, these are all players that can make big plays for them. So the Lakers have got to do everything they can to prevent those guys from really getting going. In addition to, yes, as the chat's noting, our guy Larry Nance as well. In addition to Zion Williamson, I'm going to trust LeBron to try to defend him straight up when he needs to. Rui Hachimura will get some minutes there. Look, Zion's going to get his. There's no question. Zion's going to get his. You know Brandon Ingram's going to get his. Hopefully the Lakers can pester him. Unfortunately, no Jared Vanderbilt because he's done a great job on BI in the past, just contesting on all of his shots. That's going to be a difficult challenge, I think, for Rui Hachimura, who is my guess is going to get the first try at Brandon Ingram out of the opening tip. So the Lakers have got to do what they can to at least contest on his jumpers and make him take some tough ones. Hopefully there's a little bit of rust there. But BI is going to get his. Right? Zion's going to get his. CJ McCollum's going to get up plenty of shots. Hopefully he's not on a heater in this game. Then it's on the Lakers to prevent the rest of the guys from really getting going and really getting into a rhythm, because you're a few pesky Jose Alvarado steals, a few ill-timed threes, things like that, away from a really tough night. So, or afternoon, I should say. All right, let me see here. Let me get into your chat questions real quick, and let's see what you guys have to say. You guys are asking for an update on Jared Vanderbilt. Look, guys, we asked last game. I was in Memphis for the game, and we asked for an update on Jared Vanderbilt. Darvin Ham told us there is no update, that Vando got in a good practice. I later heard that Vando was just working, you know, just with the coaches, you know, one on none, no contact, anything like that. So doesn't seem like he's anywhere close to coming. Like, you read between the lines a little bit. Even if a week from now suddenly he gets cleared for contact, and then a few days later he's good. What version of Jared Vanderbilt are you getting? He hasn't played since January. So I'm not optimistic that, number one, you're getting Jared Vanderbilt back anytime soon. And then even if you did get him back, what version of him are you getting? I think the Lakers have to look at this as they are going at it without Vando in this one. Christian Wood, there's no update on him. We heard a while ago he was out for the season. I mean, there's nothing. Nothing on Christian Wood either. Nothing to suggest he's anywhere close to coming back. If a few days from now we get an update and he's close, great. But I'd be surprised at this point. So that's where we're at. I will say that Gabe Vincent is going to be important in this game, particularly to defend a guy like CJ McCollum. Fortunately, he is back. Gabe has played well defensively, not so great on the offensive end, although he did get a three to drop last game against the Grizzlies. Maybe this is it. Maybe this will be the game. I mean, Gabe Vincent is supposed to be a big game performer. Maybe this will be the game that Gabe Vincent gets it going and the offense really starts to click for him. But all right, everybody, this is a big one. This is a big one for the Lakers. To sum it up, the Lakers, you want to look at it this way. Yes, if you win today, you're the 8th seed. Lose today, you're the 10th seed. That's the way I'm approaching this. You can also look at it like this. The Lakers have three chances to win their next two games, to win two games. They have three chances to win two games. That's the way you have to look at it between today and then potentially two play-in games. That's the way it is. You've got to win twice. So if they lose today, they have to win their next two. If they win today, they have to win one of their next two, right? That's the way it goes. Ideally, they win today, they win their next game, which would be potentially against the Pelicans again. If the Lakers win and the Suns win today, then the Lakers will play the Pelicans in the first round of the play-in tournament. So the Lakers might just wind up staying in New Orleans. Or if the Lakers win and the Suns lose, the Lakers would then go to Phoenix to play the Suns. So that's an outcome that we could see here. But if the Lakers are able to win today, they win next game, then they actually have a little bit of a break before, not much of a break, but a little bit of a break before the playoffs start. So that would certainly be the preferred path here. Win today, win the next game. Don't even have to worry about a third game, and then you can rest up for the playoffs. Otherwise, again, two wins. It's what you need, two wins in the next three. All right, everybody. I appreciate all of you guys for coming in. If you haven't done so yet, make sure you do subscribe to the Lakers Nation YouTube channel, youtube.com/LakersNation. Come join us today over on Playback, playback.tv/LakersNation. Hang out with us during the game. Oh boy, let's get through it. This is the biggest game of the season. Well, the Lakers finally step up and have a big performance. Till game time, everybody. See ya and stay safe.